Time now, once again, for Dan's favorite apps. Started with the iPhone, but we're branching out. Last night we took a look at the Droid. Tonight, a little of both.
Yeah, a little bit of both. We've got actually a sports theme tonight, apps for sports fans, and one app that I just hate. The best mobile app for sports is MLB. The bad news is the season's over. Good news, the Giants won it all. Now NFL. This app, available for iPhone and Droid, is a glorified mobile website. Its stuff is okay, and it interfaces with the NFL's very lame fantasy league program, but it's the NFL. Honestly, you expect a little more. The NHL's 2010 Game Center is kind of nice. It's got scores and standings, news. It's got a cool ice tracker feature where during the game you can follow the puck. It's got play-by-play, too. NBA Game Time here on both the Droid and the iPhone. We thought it would be fun to see them side by side. They both seem to retrieve information at close to the same speed. The Droid's a little faster, but there's not much of it because the NBA app is weak. It never loads everything, and it's just a pitch for a $10 version that promises video. If you can't load your ads in 5 minutes, how long will we have to wait for video? Not to do anything with sports, but on the subject of lame apps, from the makers of the iHome products comes Sleep, an alarm and sleep tracking app that connects with this alarm clock. The app has essentially no support. It's poorly designed, and after spending hours on it, I still don't know how it really works, and I don't care. It looks kind of nice. Then there's the fact that I blew like $80 on the alarm clock, which is also lame. The app is free, and it's not worth it. The clock you can get cheap as soon as I download the Craigslist app. Awful. Awful. By the way, in terms of, it's an alarm. How tough is that, really? The best sports app for scores and news is ESPN SportsCenter, bar none. It's on the iPhone, the Droid, and the XL version on the iPad just rocks.
Cool apps.